Then once again I welcome you all for this online class, and today we are moving into a new lesson of geography, lesson 2, and the title of our lesson is landforms. And in this lesson we are going to study about landforms that were created by rivers, landforms that were created by glacial action, landforms that were produced by wind action, and finally landforms that were created by sea waves. Okay, so when you look at the surface of our earth, it is not same everywhere, isn't it? You could see the lofty mountains, hills, and deep valleys, deserts, plains, plateaus, and lot of varieties in the landforms. Landform means the view of the land we see. Okay, the view of the land we see. So it is not same everywhere. We have different forms of land. So in this lesson we are going to focus upon how these system of land were formed, what were the agents, what are the reasons in our earth surface we have variety of land forms or land views, landscapes. Okay, so the landforms, they are brought into a change by two important processes. One is we call endogenic process, and the other one we call the exogenic process. Okay, so what is endogenic? So the name itself gives us information. That is, endo means inside, from within. So our surface of the earth is disturbed or tilted or changed by the way from the inside of the earth. So last class we studied about volcanic actions, isn't it? Volcanoes, earthquakes, they all are part of endogenic process. That is, the process happen below the earth surface. So because of some changes happening below the earth surface, we have changes in the outer surface of the earth also. So this type of process is called endogenic process. Okay, that is internal process that leads to upliftment and sinking of the earth surface at several places. So some places the land system will move up, some places it will sink down because of the internal process. Okay, so the next type is exogenic process. Exo means outer. Okay, so last class we studied about the endogenic process, and this class we are going to study about exogenic. Exogenic means outer forces that brings the changes, that makes changes in the surface of our earth. Okay, so external process, continuous wearing down and rebuilding the land surfaces are called exogenic process. So the exogenic process are the external process, not internal, like something happening below the earth surface. This happens above the earth surface. Continuous wearing down. Wearing down means breaking down or moving down or rebuilding, that is making up. So there are two ways. One is breaking down, moving down, or another one is building down, building up of the land surface. They are called exogenic process. Okay, so as we proceed on, we'll clearly understand about this exogenic process, because the whole lesson focuses about the exogenic process. Okay, so before we move further, we have to understand some important terms, words. Okay, so first important word is gradation. So what is gradation? Look at the picture, two pictures here. Okay, so previously we studied about exogenic force. it acts from outside. Okay, so these two pictures are because of the exogenic forces, they became like this. Look at the hill. Okay, the single hill. See, it is slowly, it is broken into small pieces. Okay, so the higher portion of a body is slowly pushed by some external force, and it is made into a level. Okay, it is brought up into the level, ground level area. Okay, ground level. Look at the next picture in the left side. There also you could see a pit, isn't it? A deep. So what happens? Some external forces, they push the sand which is in the high place into the lower pit. So this type is called gradation. This process is called gradation. So what is gradation? It is leveling, making it flat, leveling the high land through erosion, or filling up the lowland through deposition. Okay, deposition means moving some from one place to another place. That is called deposition, changing its position. So in the sand is depositioned from one place to another place. Erosion means breaking it up into small pieces, or destroying it in a slow process. Okay, moving it or destroying it in a slow process. Understood? This is called gradation. So everywhere in our world this process takes place. Wherever you see a elevated portion, elevated body, the external forces, maybe we have more external forces. It could be a wind, or it could be water. Any external force, they push it. Okay, they erode it and they bring it to the down ground level. Okay. Okay, so now we are going to focus upon what are the ways our landscape is broken down. Okay, it is destroyed. Okay, so the landscape, landforms are broken down or destroyed by two processes. One is weathering process, another one is erosion process. So first we'll study what is weathering process. See, look at the background picture here. A rock is broken into two parts, isn't it? So this is called weathering process, that is through external force. Okay, the body, it will be break up into small pieces. The rock part will be broken up into small pieces, and they will be forced into the surface of the earth. So this is called weathering. Weathering means breaking up of rocks into small pieces. Okay, so by this way, maybe this rock is broken by the wind. Okay, continuous flow of wind, the rock becomes weaker and it started to crack in some place. So what happens? Slowly, furthermore, this rock will be again broken up into pieces, and slowly the erected rock, it will be leveled to the ground, it will be pushed to the ground. This process is called weathering, breaking down into small pieces the rocks. Okay, erosion means, look at the picture here. This is called erosion. See the winds, isn't it? Winds, the air system in the atmosphere, they have pushed a large hill. Okay, they broken up the large wear down. Okay, broken down. So this type of wearing down the land system by different types of external forces like water or wind or ice or even sea water, we call them erosion. In Tamil, we use aripu. Okay, aripu, that is gradually, slowly breaking something into pieces, we call it erosion. So our landscape, the landforms are broken up into pieces. They were worn out by two ways. One is weathering way, another one is erosion. Okay, weathering means breaking into pieces. Okay, erosion means wearing away the landscape by different agents. Okay, the erosion is caused by different materials. Okay, external forces. They may be water or wind or ice or even sea waves. Okay, so the process of erosion or deposition, okay, create different landforms on the earth's surface. Okay, now we are going to focus upon the water system. What are the changes the water system brings on the surface of our earth? Okay, what type of erosion it brings to the earth surface? Okay, so first we are focusing upon the water system, that is rivers. So first let's define what is river. The water flowing from its source to river mouth along a definite course is called a river. Okay, so what the definition says, the water flowing from its source means, look at the picture on the left side, starting point, originating place, that is from mountains. Okay, so what is the end point of the river? River mouth. Look at the picture on the right side, it ends up in a sea. Okay, so the water flowing from its source up to the river mouth along a definite path, definite course means a particular place. Okay, the particular path, this is called a river. Okay, so rivers are generally originate from mountains or hills. So the places of origin of the river is known as its source. Okay, so the hills or mountains from where the river originate, we call it source, and the place where it ends, we call it river mouth. Okay, so what are the changes the river water can make in the surface of the earth? First change it could make is V-shaped valley. See, look at the picture, background picture in the display. Okay, so look at this valley. It is steep in both sides, isn't it? Slope in both sides, and at the bottom we could see a small river, isn't it? So these type of V-shaped valleys are because of the erosion brought by the river water. Okay, slowly it broken up the portions of the mount hill into small piece, and because of it the V-shaped valleys were formed. Okay, so the river water made an impact. Okay, it brought a change in the mountain by eroding the surface of the mountain and made it into a V-shaped picture. So it is called V-shaped valley. Okay, then we are going to study about two important parts of rivers. Okay, one is distributary and another one is tributary. So what is distributary? Look at the picture in the left, a stream that branches off and flows away from a main stream. So when the river runs, okay, when the river water moves from its path, okay, so the river water, it will branch into other branches, isn't it? It move and it become another branch. So these branches are called distributaries. The river water taking diversion and it moves in another way, it takes a divergent, okay, diversion, we call it distributary. What is meant by tributary? It is exactly opposite to it. Other water sources, they come and join into the main river. See right side picture. See, there are other water system. Other water system, they come and meet the main river, join them, and the waters are collected in the main river. So these types are called tributaries. Okay, so distributary means water, river water branching out and moving away from the river. Okay, tributary means other water source joining into the main river. Okay, then what are the another form of change brought by the river water is waterfall. Okay, you all might have seen waterfalls, isn't it? So what is a waterfall? Falling of river water over a vertical step in the river bed is called waterfall. So whenever the river water flows from a higher elevated point into the lower form of surface of the earth, we call it waterfall. So how a waterfall is formed? It is formed when the soft rocks are removed by erosion. Okay, so the topmost rocks will be very soft because of water always moving on them. Okay, so the soft rocks will be eroded gradually and it forms a waterfall. Okay, so example, Kottalam Falls. Okay, it is formed in the river Chittar in Tamil Nadu. So the highest waterfall in the world is Angel Falls in Venezuela, which is in Southern America. So other important falls are Niagara Falls in Canada and Victoria Falls in Africa. Okay, so these are changes brought by the water system in the surface of the earth. So the next topic is what is plunge pool. Okay, so when the waterfall, it forces into the ground. Okay, when it pushes and falls into the ground, okay, it forms a base. Okay, it forms a hollow base. It is also called cavity. Okay, cavitation. It makes a deep impression. So that deep impression is called plunge pool. Okay, so look at the picture here. At the bottom you could see a round cavity. So this round deep path created by the force of waterfall, we call it plunge pool. Okay, then alluvial fan. So what is alluvial fan? It is a fan or cone shaped deposit of sediment built up by river streams. Okay, so when the river water branches out, okay, when it divides into small distributaries, okay, so what happens? It forms like a cone shaped or fan shaped deposit. It forms a sediment deposit of the sand. Okay, so this is called alluvial fan. Look at the dark colored shade in the picture. Okay, that is the alluvial fan. It is formed because of the river water distributed into several branches. Okay, meanders. What are meanders? So look at the picture here. You could see the zigzag movement of the river water, isn't it? It moves like a bend shaped, U-shaped bend. So these types of twist formed by the river water, they are known as meanders, the bend type. So when the river water enters the plain, it twists and turns, forming large bends. So these large bends are known as meanders. So example for meander rivers in Tamil Nadu is River Vellar near Sethyathop in Kadalur district in Tamil Nadu. Okay, so the large bend is known as the meanders. Okay, what is Oxbow Lake formation? So look at the picture here. So this is the path of a river. So what happened? The bending river slowly, because of erosion, what happens? It slowly the surface of the river, it started to erode and it start to meet with the other portion of the river. So it was in the beginning, it was a curve-like bend. Slowly, what happens? The curve will be cut off, dissected from the main river, and it becomes a small lake. Okay, so this curve-shaped lake is called Oxbow Lake Formation because it looks like the shoe, the foot path of a ox. So it is called Oxbow Lake Formation. Okay, so the definition is here. Due to continuous erosion and deposition along the sides of the meander, the ends of the meander loop comes closer and closer, and in due course of time, the meander loops cut off from the river and forms a cut-off lake, and it is called Oxbow Lake. See here, in the picture you could have seen, isn't it? So it is a continuous erosion and deposition of meander. Okay, so the loop slowly comes closer and closer in due time, and finally they join together and moving away the bend portion from the mainstream. Okay, so the cut-off lake will form a separate lake which is called Oxbow Lake. Okay, so at time the river overflows. Okay, now we are going to study about what are foot flood plain and levees. Okay, foot plain and flood plain and levees. So when you look at the background picture, you could see the river water, and the borders of the river water are little bit higher. Okay, they are little bit elevated, and you could see other portion straight plains. Okay, so at some times the river flows overflows its banks. Okay, the river water, it will overflow and it will lead to a flooding to the neighboring areas. So when the river water move from its boundary and it moves further more highly, then it becomes a flood, isn't it? So when the river floods, okay, it deposits fine soils in the places where they overflow. Okay, so these overflowing fine soils are called sediments. So these sediments are rich soil which is suitable for agriculture. So these type of formation of flat plains are called flood plains, and they are very fertile. And the raised banks at the mouth of the at the border of the river, they are called levees. Okay, so finally we are going to study what is a delta. So look at the picture here. When a river water, when it finally reaches its end point, the river becomes slow and it breaks into smaller distributaries. Okay, because of less speed in the river water, it's break up into several distributaries. Okay, so what happened? These several distributaries, in due course of time, they forms sediments. Okay, fine soil sediments at the mouth of the distributaries. So the fine sediments are called deltas. In the picture, look at the dark brown portions. They are the fertile sediments formed by the distributaries of a river. Okay, so example is the delta region of our Tamil Nadu. They are the best examples. Tanjavur. Okay, so the soil in Tanjavur is very fertile, and people are using the land for agricultural purpose, isn't it? So you know why those soil are very fertile? Because they form because of the Kaveri Delta region. The Kaveri River, it finally ends, it forms distributaries, and because of these distributaries, the adjoining, the nearby land becomes very fertile because of the sediments of the river water. And because of the fertile land, agriculture is very much possible and the delta regions are producing more crops. Okay, children. So in today's class, we studied about the changes brought by the external forces in the form of rivers in the external surface of the earth. In the next class, we'll study about what are the changes brought by the glacial ice and what are the changes made into the surface of our earth by the wind action and finally sea wave action. Okay, children. Okay, we'll see in the next class. See you all. Bye.